Let me first say I'm so sorry. I know I haven't been on YouTube for a really long time. I actually went traveling, so I wasn't able to kind of push out content as I normally would. But you can see everything I ate overseas on Instagram and Facebook, and believe me, did I eat. So, what better way to make my YouTube comeback than with one of London's most hotly anticipated openings for 2018, Hyde Restaurant, by one of Britain's most well-respected chefs, Ollie Debou. He's a Michelin star guy. Now, Hyde is a bit of an anomaly, probably one of the most extravagant restaurants to have opened in London for 2018. It cost £20 million to build. This place is huge. It's spread over three floors, and you walk in and you're just overwhelmed by the sheer size of it all. So there are two parts to Hyde. Downstairs is more casual, and the upstairs is called Hyde Above. The difference between the two is I actually was able to order a la carte on the downstairs floor, whereas upstairs had the set menu. I wanted to have that little bit of variety and freedom of choice, so I went for the a la carte option. What I've read is that the restaurant has asked the Michelin guide to treat the two floors as two separate restaurants. So detail is paramount at Hyde. There's just so much to look at. The entire restaurant is modeled on a tree. So you've got a sweeping curved oak staircase, which is in the center of the room, and it's really the focal point. But then you also go inside the lift and you have a tiny model of the entire restaurant. You had this beautiful oak bar.
Hello!
And then you've got these kind of dark, rough wood walls that frame every room, whether it's a private dining room or the bathroom. And speaking of private dining room, let's get to that. Wait, you think that's opulent? There's another even more exclusive private dining room which you can drive to because there's a car lift in the building. So all of the critics have been raving about Hyde. What I do with restaurants which have a lot of hype is order at least one dish which I'm a little dubious of to see if it will change my mind. That dish was a tartare of Orkney scallops with iced eucalyptus. There was smoke everywhere because it was dried ice. It was very dramatic. I was actually filming and my hair almost touched the ice, so the waiters were kind of freaking out. I took my first bite straight away, so I was overwhelmed by the pure temperature of the dish. It was freezing cold. I decided to lay off, give the dish a little bit of time to settle before I had my next bite. As you know, scallop absorbs every kind of flavor that you toss at it. As a whole, there were very clean flavors. You know, you've got that kind of sinus clearing eucalyptus in there. And you also had cucumber, which gave an audible crunch every time you bit into it. There was a mint green reduction under the initial top layer, which developed much more flavor once the initial extreme temperatures of the dish diminished. I wasn't entirely sure if my sensitive teeth could handle the cold. Did it change my mind on scallops? No, but it was a cool experience anyway. No pun intended. That was really lame. Moving on. The second dish I had was the barbecued Iberico pork with date syrup, fennel, and peach. It was really fresh, it was acidic, it had two different cuts of pork on it. I found that the cheek had more flavor and more roundness. Because the weather is a little bit awkward right now, you know, it's not quite hot, it's not quite cool, so I wasn't able to fully get into this dish until I put all of the flavors onto one spoon. The additional flavors were a smattering of cashew nuts and also black Kalamata olive powder was the adhesive to the dish. The leaves that are scattered around the dish is called a sweet Sicily leaf. So admittedly, it was a dish that grew on me, and in the end, I had one peach left to spare. For dessert, I decided to forego the traditional sweet option. I noticed they had a huge cheese cart and I really wanted to sample all the different types. So that's what I did. They also had a huge tea selection. I guess the point of difference with Hyde is the fact that it's backed by the guys who are behind Hedonism Wines, which means they have over 6,500 wines on offer. Now, I did something probably really silly. I didn't drink. I feel like it obviously limited the experience for me a little bit. You know, you can't have that extreme depth of everything if you don't go for what, you know, the restaurant is known for. Having said that, I was by myself and I was filming and I didn't want to be drunk. What did I think of Hyde? I think it was a great experience. It was very pleasant. What I really liked about Hyde was the decor wasn't vulgar or ostentatious in any way. Thank you so much for watching, guys. If you like the series, don't forget to subscribe. Also, check out my other videos. I do Michelin star videos all over the world. Anyways, guys, I will talk to you really soon. Have a great week and don't forget to eat a lot.